Welcome to the SOLIDWORKS video tutorials. In this video tutorial, we'll see how to use rectangle option in SOLIDWORKS 2019. Now, so I select sketch, I select this plane as a drawing plane, and then I select the rectangle command. Now I can see over here there are five different types of rectangles. The first one is known as corner rectangle. The second one is known as center rectangle. The third one is known as 3-point corner rectangle, and the fourth one over here is 3-point center rectangle, and the fifth one is, you can see as it is, parallelogram. I will see, we'll see the all these type of rectangles one by one. Now first of all, I have selected this rectangle. Now for this rectangle, I have to specify two diagonal points of this rectangle, that is two corner points. Now first point I specified this point, and second one I specified this point. Now we drawn this rectangle. Second option over here, that is the center rectangle. Now for center rectangle, I have to specify the center. Now suppose I select this point as my center, and then I have to specify the corner point. Okay, as you can see over here, that is, we have to specify center, and then point 2 is corner point. Over here, both are corner points. Now here I select this as my corner point. Okay, then we generated this. Now we can see that in second option, actually we have two different types of option. That is, for this type of this second rectangle, which is center rectangle, we have two options, that is from corners and from midpoints. What do you mean by this? When I select this option from corners and I draw this type of rectangle, then what difference you can see, that the corner are, these corner points are joined by these diagonal lines, which are basically construction lines. Now when I again select this rectangle, I selected this center rectangle, and now I select from midpoints option. Now when I select this option, what we can see, that I've generated this rectangle, and here we can see that midpoints are getting joined, and here these corner points are getting joined. So this is basic difference between these two options. I will see the third type of rectangle, that is over here, is 3-point corner rectangle. I select this option. A 3-point corner rectangle, I have to specify the two collinear points and third non-collinear points. First point, second point should be collinear with first point. Obviously, any two points are always collinear, but all three points cannot be collinear. Hence, we have to select two points collinear and third point non-collinear point. Now we can see we have generated this type of rectangle, and fourth type of rectangle over here is center, 3-point center rectangle. I select this option. Again, I have these two options. Again, we have seen this option from corners and from midpoints. Here we don't have this option. Only in second type of rectangle we have this option, that is from corners and from midpoints. Again, we can observe this option in our fourth type of rectangle, that is 3-point center rectangle. Okay, we'll see. We have to specify first point as center, second point as a midpoint of one of the side of this rectangle, and third point is corner of this rectangle. First of all, I select center, then midpoint, and then again corner of this rectangle. Now here we have these two options, because we have selected this corner from corner option, so we can see that corners are getting joined. Okay, now the fourth or the fifth option over here is parallelogram. Now when I select parallelogram, I have to select 3 points. Okay, in order to draw this parallelogram, we have to select 3 points. First point over here, second point, and then we can incline the third point. Okay, we can incline this third point, because parallelograms, two opposite sides are always parallel to each other. Okay, they are, and two adjacent sides are never perpendicular to each other. They always make acute angle or obtuse angle. No, they always make acute angle with respect to each other. Okay, so in this case we can see that these two lines are making acute angle, but these two lines are making obtuse angle. Okay, similarly over here, these two lines are making obtuse angle with respect to each other, and these two lines are making acute angle. Now always these two angle between these two lines is always equal to the angle between these two lines, because these two lines are always parallel and these two lines are always parallel. So in this way, we have seen the different types of rectangle options in SOLIDWORKS 2019. In our next video tutorials, we'll see all other options in sketch commands.